Hello, what's happening? Matt, a.k.a. Lethal Frag here, and today we're going to be talking about gaming addiction, and you know how it forms, and you know what it's about, and how it affects us as gamers, as players. And a lot of people will say, oh, gaming has no, you know, bad side effects and all that, but I mean, here's the reality of the situation, is gaming is addictive. And the reason it is addictive, it's a little bit like drugs for us. And I'm going to use a couple examples here to kind of explain what I'm saying and talk about how gaming forms an addiction and, you know, the effect it does have on us and sometimes stops us from having fun while we game. So I'm going to use the example of a Call of Duty game here. And we're going to talk about going for that big kill streak. And let's use Black Ops for an example, or Modern Warfare 3, going for the MOAB, going for dogs, whatever the case may be, you're going for that big kill streak, and you get to within two of your kill streak. And what happens at this point is your heart race goes up, you start racing, you know, your mind's going, you start sweating a little bit, and really the chemistry in your brain has changed at this point. And in some points, people that go for these kill streaks all the time, and I've been guilty of this, I have definitely fallen into this boat, is you're chasing that high of reaching that kill streak, and it's not even so much the moment of using that kill streak, of letting the dogs go, it's that moment right before you get there. That's when the absolute peak is, when your brain is freaking out, when your body's super excited. And what you'll find is, this is how gaming addiction forms, and why people will sit and play for 14, 16 hours a day, is because they're chasing that high. And I call it a high because it absolutely is. Your brain chemistry changes, your entire body, everything about you changes during that 30 to 45 second window where you get that intense rush like you're just about to get there. And I mean, this can apply to all sorts of games. And I mean, I've certainly taken, you know, my gaming not in moderation before. I have gamed too much in an unhealthy way. I game a lot right now. I'm trying to take better care of my body while I do so. But getting down to the core of this commentary, talking about how gaming addiction can sometimes take away the fun. And I mean, there is such a thing as too much of a good thing. And when you start playing for 14, 16 hours a day, you'll get that rush, but it becomes more and more dull. You know, I went through a pretty good streak in Black Ops where I was going for Dogs and Chopper Gunner. And when you start getting there on a very consistent basis, you're chasing something that doesn't really give you the thrill anymore, yet you keep going back trying to get that same exhilarating rush that you got before. You know, everybody's personality is different. Not everybody falls into this category. I know I certainly do, that I have an addictive personality, and you know, I didn't really recognize it. And what made me recognize it was this game right here. Because Twisted Metal, just this little demo, is the first time that I've actually had, I guess I would say, fun gaming in quite some time. You know, fun is a relative term, and some people think that getting a nuke, MOAB, Dog Chop Gunner is their idea of fun. But, you know, this game is just pure, unrelenting carnage. It's not a big deal if you die, you just respawn and get right back into the action. It's the first time I've noticed I've actually had fun playing a game, and you know, I really don't even know how long. It's been a really long time since I've had fun gaming. And I'll throw Star Wars in here. I really enjoy the Old Republic, but it's more of an addiction than a fun factor for me. It's the addiction of leveling up, ranking up, getting gear. It's not even that the game is so much, you know, fun to play. In fact, it sometimes is kind of drab and boring. But you're chasing that grind. You're chasing the level up. You're chasing that new piece of gear. So really, that's the majority of my thoughts on gaming and addiction. And you know, it's something you really have to notice and be careful of. If you notice that you're playing games and you're raging all the time, it might not be because you're playing poorly. It might be because you're not achieving that brain chemistry that you once had. And I think I really do. This is why so many first-person shooter players are so damn angry, is because they have such a blast when they first start playing, and then the reason it becomes so upsetting for them not to reach that kill streak is because they've failed to get their high. They've failed to get to that point in their brain where they feel satisfied. You know, it goes for anything, smoking, drugs, all this stuff. You want it because you want your brain chemistry to be changed, and when you fail to reach that point, it becomes more and more upsetting. So if you go 3 or 4 days without getting your nuke, you're going to be an angry individual, because that's the only reason that you're left playing that game if you're a hardcore player. And, you know, this is really one of the reasons that I kind of wanted to get away from first-person shooters. I took a lot of time and reflected on it when I decided to quit Call of Duty, and I was thinking about the reasons why I play them so much and how many hours over the years I've actually put into, you know, gaming on first-person shooters. And I had to take a hard look back and say, why did I put so many hours into this game when it's the same thing over and over again? And, you know, I just kind of had an epiphany moment. I was like, oh, I was essentially trying to get high. And a lot of people don't want to hear this. They don't want to say, oh, I'm addicted to gaming. And you know what? I'm addicted to gaming. And I've been addicted to gaming for a really long time. I don't necessarily think that's unhealthy if you can keep it in balance with the rest of your life. But first-person shooters, more than anything, offer that that ultimate rush. I mean, whatever it is, that's what makes gaming fun for people, is that those intense moments, those few moments where it's actually hard, and this is why it's hard to play a game that's super easy for a long time, is you're never achieving that. I mean, doesn't it feel great to beat the final boss, or, you know, die 4 times on a final boss and then finally get him? You get that huge rush of emotion that you finally got there. And, you know, I just want to take a little deeper look on why we game, and, you know, what are our reasons before gaming? What is your reason for gaming so much? I have nothing against people that game for 14 hours a day. I don't think it's healthy. I understand the lifestyle because I've lived it myself. And I really don't think there's that much wrong with it other than it being bad for your body. But, I mean, if you can hold down your school, you can hold down your job, you can be relatively healthy while maintaining that lifestyle, and that makes you happy, there is absolutely nothing wrong with that. But be careful of the pitfall of getting into that mode where the only thing that's making you happy, gaming, is reaching that high. And, you know, it took me a really long time to realize that. Like I said, I had an epiphany moment. And it's really crazy to think about that I was just chasing that over and over again. And I'm very good at first-person shooters, and the reason is I put in so many hours. But be careful of that pitfall, guys. I mean, if you're gaming that much and you're angry while you're playing, take a step back and think about, why am I actually gaming right now? What am I trying to get out of my session? And the bottom line is, gaming should be fun for you, and you shouldn't have to reach that peak moment for it to be a good time. You know, go out and play a game, an old school game, one that was fun for you. Go enjoy yourself again and see what that feels like, because that's what gaming really should be about. It shouldn't be about that, you know, that adrenaline rush. And while there's nothing wrong with that feeling, it's a very good feeling, do not fall into that pitfall, guys. It is the most dangerous thing you can do as a gamer, and I can say that hands down, because I've been there and done it. Just be careful. That's all I'm saying. That's about all I got on the subject. Thanks so much for listening, guys. That's all I got. Frag out.
Gunner killed. Random weapon awarded. 1 minute to go.